have a gift that you want to give to Lionel, bring it to.
Madam.
I wasn't able to sleep all week, and I'm sure a lot of you guys have been having the same issue. The morning when I got the call, I was sleeping, and I'm not sure about most of you. When you first wake up, you don't hear clearly. So my best friend is telling me so-and-so has been shot. And I'm like, who? And she's saying the name. I'm like, all right, whatever, because I can't take her seriously because there's no way this matches up with this name. So then I finally rolled out of bed. I called her again, and she's crying. I'm like, ooh. She's like, Lionel. I dropped down on the floor, started crying. I'm shaking right now as you speak. I brushed my teeth. Mind you, I had my bonnet, my African dashiki on, and my flip-flops. I walked over to this, well, I took my car, went to his house, just to see if this was true. She's already there, a couple of people at his house. I started crying. I said, tell me this is not real. Tell me this is not real. But indeed, it was real, and it's very sad. But one thing I can say about Lionel was rich. When I say rich, I don't mean rich in money. You have to be rich in spirit and rich in soul to get this amount of people to gather here to celebrate you. We're not mourning him, we're celebrating him. And for that, I admire him, because that's something that all of us will want to leave this earth knowing. That we can leave such a big impact. One thing that I want all of us to remember and why we should value life, my mom always told me, not everyone who say good morning, say good night. So if we remember that, we'll value our life so much more. Lionel, you don't have to invite him anywhere. He shows up. And when he shows up, he makes sure that you know he's there, and he just gives you so much love. While at school, while I'm trying to get my degree, every time I'm like, I'm gonna give up, I can't do this, I can't do that. She's like, you know we Africans, we don't give up, what do you mean? And then, you know, just like she said earlier, you'll do the thing, see your life, and I'll be like, hi, I can't quit. But he'll continue to push me, he'll motivate me. He'll say, I'm so proud of you. One thing, I'm so happy I got to do, I got to tell him how proud I am of him. Tell his word. So please, Lionel, love you, and I thank you all these years to celebrate me. Even at times when I forget to call you, you made sure that you showed up. Thank you for being a big brother. Thank you for being my fake cousin, and thank you for always being there for me. And I just love you. Thank you.
If you don't have a face mask, let me know. I'll provide you with one. And also, if you need a candle, let me know. We'll provide you with one as well.
My name is Janae, and I knew Lionel. Very positive person, very strong, very happy, full of energy.
Good, how are you?
Good, my name is Sanjay. I moved there about 14 years ago from Jamaica, and it was definitely a new experience being here and everything like that, not knowing anyone. And Lionel was one of the few people, persons, that I remember that was always friendly to me. Like, every time he would see me, he would pop out with a little, yo, wah, wah. So that made me feel welcome and loved. And, you know, Team Franklin had their crew. They used to dance and everything like that. And every so often, I would be with my crew. I'd be with the dance team. So every now and then, I'd bump into the guys. And Lionel would be one of the guys in the crew that would know the Jamaican dancing and stuff like that. And even to this very day, this year, something personal was going on in my life that, you know, we all go through some dark times. And it was one of his poems that he wrote that brought me back to life. You know what I mean? I know you guys have heard his music before. And I'm saying all this to say that during these trying times, you know, the Holy Spirit are dawning on certain people. And Lionel was one of those brothers who had the Holy Spirit. Can I get an amen?
Amen!
That's right. So, as sad as this is, we should more focus on his life and the people he has touched. Because I'm one of them. And I'm still going because of Lionel. Alright, so can I say, when I say blessed, can I get a grateful?
Let's go.
Blessed?
Grateful!
Blessed?
Grateful!
Alright, that's it. God bless you guys.
And Lionel never let me feel that way. He gave
Like the same mantras from football practice. Coach Gordon used to say, if you was ever gonna make a mistake, go 100 miles per hour doing it. I bet you that lived with all of y'all too. Lionel traveled the world. He shook every hand, kissed every baby, joined every team, loved everybody. Difference in this community, we made a difference in this state, we made a difference in this world.
Dessert.
Every mistake we make, we're gonna do it 100 miles per hour.
Guido.
To be honest with you, being here doesn't feel real. Every other day going over to his house, and even being there, it just feels like we're just all sitting outside waiting for him to drive up. I met Lionel in preschool, like Scat. I don't know if I know about
Street.
You know, that was like ashy knees and booger nose. Like. But he was older than me, so it wasn't up until like I got into high school that I got closer to him. Because I don't know if you know, like, the years between 2009 and, like, 2014-15, it was, like, a blended class. So everybody was together. I want to talk to you guys about the last time I saw Lionel. And it's kind of rings true to what everybody else is saying here. I needed help. I texted him because I was doing a project for the seniors at the high school. I hit him up at, like, 10 o'clock at night. He was like, yo, here's the Addy, scoop me in the morning. I was like, thank you, I appreciate that. And we sat in front of the high school, we talked about the project. He helped me pack gifts. We had dinner that day, and he left. That was the last time I saw him. And when I think back to that moment, and I think about the last few days, I've kind of been dealing with this question about what karma is. Because to be someone that had that much life and to do that much good and still be in the situation that you are right now, it feels crazy. But I know for a fact, for the last week, I've been grateful every single morning I wake up. Every single day, I'm happy to be here because he was happy to be here. So I just wanted to come out here and just like, if it hasn't soaked in already, that we really should be blessed and grateful about our existence on this earth. Because he didn't expect any of this stuff to happen when he woke up that morning.
He was still blessed and grateful.
And still. I just want to say from the bottom of my heart, I love every single one of you. Hope we all make good decisions. And that we be able to live out the course of our life that we expected to.
Love you.
What saddens me is that his life was cut short. We all have questions sometimes that just cannot be answered. Heaven gained an angel, and that's a positive way of looking at it. He's here with us.
I have a few words from Jasmine. She wasn't able to make it tonight. She sends her apology, but I will read this for her. Lionel McCauley was an amazing, talented person. Always positive, genuine, supportive, and kind.
His life and legacy mattered. I will never pretend to know the pain his family is going through. My prayers are with them. I hope Lionel is proud of us today. I hope he feels the love of all the way from here to the table of kings he now sits with in heaven.
I really just wanted to be with all of you today. I was not planning on saying anything. I am blessed. And I am grateful to be here with you today. I am blessed and I am grateful to serve the church where Lionel grew up. I am blessed and grateful to be surrounded by a family that loved Lionel, that walked with Lionel, that are grieving deeply right now. And so I wanted to just take a few minutes to talk with you and offer a word of prayer and comfort for all of you. So I didn't get to, Lionel and I met, it was briefly after worship Sunday, but he had been traveling and I've only been here for a short while. So when I came with to the family on Sunday after church, I said, tell me about Lionel, I want to know about him. And the stories were, it didn't matter who you were, Lionel would run up to you, give you a compliment, and then just hug you with this incredibly deep hug. And it didn't matter who you were, he would offer you that love.
So I went home, and I wasn't gonna get up here, but I kept hearing him, like, you got this, bro. Like, people love you, like, it's okay, you know? I'm honored. Have been there for you in your last moment when you decided to leave this earth. And I appreciate you choosing me for that. Being around a lot of people, I didn't really feel like, you know, loved, and Lionel made me feel loved. And now I know that y'all are my extended family forever. All of Lionel's brothers are now my brothers. But these last couple days have been really hard. But Lionel has a lot to say, and I was telling his brother that after that moment, I was the only one that knew, and I couldn't tell nobody.
Lionel was right here with us, he's smiling down with his beautiful smile. You know, he's connected with everybody out here in Franklin. And I'm just so blessed to actually be out here with you guys. I know Lionel would have loved that. And I've been looking at his Instagram lately, and it's just so crazy how talented Lionel was. Y'all go through and listen to the stories he told. I know some of y'all shared those stories with him. He's such an amazing person. It got me thinking, like, we got an angel with us, you know? We got an angel with us, and we should hold our head up, because Lionel is always going to be there with us. I remember at my low moments, whether it was track or just in life, Lionel had the positivity to just get above it. Anytime, even if Lionel failed, like Freeman said. No dress-up clothes, all that ideas. You come up to them like, hey, what are you doing? Hey, I'm Lionel, what up? And I'm like, that confidence right there just speaks for itself. Lionel had the confidence to keep driving. He had the confidence to be anything he wanted to be. I remember talking to him on the phone, and you know, Lionel, you don't know what Lionel about to do. Lionel has so many endeavors. And I'm talking to him on the phone, he's telling me he got this, he's gonna do a spoken word mixtape. And I'm like, I never heard of that. I'm like, how is that gonna come? That was an awkward conversation. I ain't had nothing to give him. But then when I heard it, man, such an amazing album, such a delivery of words. I don't know how Lionel had all this talent, but man, I'm so blessed. I'm so blessed to be able to wait to grow up with Lionel and witness the amazing things he's done and bringing everybody together. And I'm blessed that you guys are here. Let's hold our head up. Be blessed and grateful. Love you, Lionel, forever.
Warriors!
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 What's up, y'all? I'm Josh. My boy is Clay. Chu.
Y'all know us.
Lionel was a great guy. Lionel, there was one time, we were celebrating my mom's 50th birthday. He always had good energy, always wanted to uplift somebody. In high school, he was always asking for $1 so that he could go buy Pop-Tarts from this guy. He always sell Pop-Tarts out of his locker.
Out of my locker.
Oh.
Just come out.
So, I mean, Lionel was never afraid to ask for anything. He was never afraid to also do a favor to somebody. He was always there to ride for somebody.
So, hello! My name is Ashley Antonia Lopez.
Okay, girl.
Okay.
If there's one thing that he will say, if you look at his Instagram, he will say, be blessed and grateful, right? He will say, the one thing that you say, oh, I wish I can do, do it. Why are you waiting? Another thing he would say is, if you can help somebody, do it. Why are you waiting? I met Lionel in 2017. I'm an actor, and we did 3/5 together. The hardest thing in the entire life, but I was gravitated to him. And I've been grateful and blessed to have him in my life. So if you're an actor, please go act. If you're a producer, produce. Just be happy and enjoy life. If you could travel, go ahead and travel. This love. So thank you.
But that boy Will couldn't be broke. He was strong. I noticed the confidence in him. And I seen myself in him. And I became a fan of him. And I would tell him as well as some of the youngsters that's out here, y'all the future right here. Y'all the ones that's gonna take over this court. You know what I mean? They was already taking over the court. We old school now. So we lucky to play with them. You know? They mix us up with them. But we love Lionel. When we had the news, my daughter told me we was heartbroken. Heartbroken. Very positive, brother. Always respectful to any of us up here. And I seen Lionel on the street many times in different places and different faces. Always show me respect. We barely knew each other's name. We knew each other just for playing here every Sunday. We became kindred spirits. And everybody that come up here on Sundays, we all become kindred spirits. We all won. And we had a lot of fun, a lot of good times, a lot of beautiful days. And we gonna miss Brother Lionel. Respect, King.
Yeah, y'all can clap. Come on, just get some energy in there. In the air.
Yo, peace, fam.
Peace.
Oh, no, we gonna do better than that. Peace, fam.
Peace.
I'm an actor. And I met Lionel 3 years ago with Ashley in a play that we did called 3/5. Now, the point of the play was talking about how we as black people were considered to be 3/5 of a man in this country. To show the atrocities and the hurt and the pain of this system, it involved for his character to be naked on stage. Now, I was in a different part of the theater, so I didn't know that. The whole time, I was assuming that, okay, he must be wearing underwear or some thong or something. So one day we were backstage and we were talking about that part. I'm like, yo, what happens on that part of the scene? And he's like, yo, I'm naked out there.
Yeah.
Like, what you mean you naked out there? You wearing like drawers, you know, Speedos or something, right? He's like, nah, I'm out there in the buff. I'm like, yo, that's dedication.
Yes.
Now, I've been acting, I've been doing spoken word for a number of years, possibly longer than him. I still ain't got that type of dedication. I'm saying all this to say how you take that type of soul with that type of dedication for the art, for the craft. Yo, man, I love that dude, man. They messed around and took a good one.
Yeah.
Ashley left me that voicemail and my heart just broke on the train. I was like, nah, I must have heard wrong. Not him. That's a good dude, not him. So when I called to confirm, it hurt. But I had to be here, just like all of us had to be here, to give our farewells to a really great dude. If you have something that you really want to do, man, go out there and do it. Between this and this whole COVID business, yo, life is precious, man. At any moment, any day, any time, be happy that you're here. For real, this hurts. This really hurts. I don't know anybody out here that's from Sierra Leone or from Freetown, Sierra Leone.
We did. Yeah.
My people, my family. He used to always joke around when I found out he was from Sierra Leone, just like my family. I used to say, this not me, brother. This not me, fumble. People would text me and call me like, yo, D, I know you had another brother. No, I'm just joking around, but we had that closeness, we had that bond from jump. And when you know that that type of bond is taken away from you, that hurts. So please, man, whatever bonds y'all had, whatever togetherness you have with somebody, whatever issues or beefs you got with somebody, squash all that. Be precious, and cherish those connections that you got. Because as we're all being reminded right now, it can be taken away from you. Man, I love y'all. Love yourselves and love each other, man. Peace to Lionel, man. Peace, brother.
Tyrone Taylor. I teach at Kane University business. First of all, started off every meeting with prayer. And that prayer was to give God to give us the strength to be the best that we can be, to have us speak the things that one of us can be all that we can be. And I'm grateful to him for bringing that and making sure that we did that every time we met. I say all this to say, Lionel would have want all of us to start the day off with a prayer, to start the day off thanking the Mighty High for all that you have in life. I think that's why he would always say, today, blessed, grateful. He would always tell me, and I'll end with this, as you say, Lionel, I don't know why we're not getting these, you know, these major roles. I don't understand why it's not happening. All we've seen is in God's time, it will happen. In God's time, it will happen. I'm sure some of you will know that he says that. In God's time, it will happen. I appreciate the brethren who came to my graduation when I graduated. He's been at any event, every event that I've ever invited him to. He's very supportive. He loved his family, loved all his friends, and it's just a real, real big loss. It's not an hour that goes by that I don't think about him, because again, sitting across the table from him every week to talk about life, and not have that anymore, it's just very hurtful. But I'm holding it together right now for all of us, for all of you, for Lionel, to share that story with you. And again, first of all, just go for it. Keep God first, your family up there, and stay strong, stay positive. Let's celebrate today. Let's not be sad. Let's celebrate. You might have been a good
one. Rational and nervous. He was always so just chilled and relaxed and laid back. And I watched him, this was improv. So I watched him freestyle off the dome with all of his different characters that he had. And I remember thinking, like, wow, I'm honored to even be in the same project as somebody like this. And Lionel had a way of being.
And this guy brought about peace, love, happiness, positivity. It was very positive. And he jokes a lot. And when he found out I was African, it's like I was his brother. He was like, oh, you're Nigerian? Hey, my brother. Come to my house. You know, it's like we're talking, we're vibing. We sat in the car for like.
Grateful.
Know what to say, you feel me? I just know this. I done cried it out. I done did everything I had to do as far as, you know. I just know, you know, today I feel like if anything, Lionel won, everybody would really turn up. If I felt any other way how it was supposed to go, me knowing Lionel, my personal relationship with Lionel, everybody knows how, you know, he want everybody to go up. I don't think he want everybody to be sad. I'm choked up right now, so it's going to come out weird, you feel me? I wasn't ready to speak or anything, but it's a bit. But I came here today to have his spirit really lift me, you know what I'm saying? And I know Lionel is not one a whole bunch of sadness. I'm sad, you know what I mean? Like, it hurts to talk about, it's weird. I really don't know what to say, but if y'all got some liquor. If you got some liquor, I need y'all to take a shot for Lionel. I don't need anybody over here leaving this joint sad, depressed, or anything, because I know that's not his vibe. You know what I'm saying? Like, I want to match his energy. I know how he come. I know Lionel would be up there. If they play the Team Franklin anthem today, I'm going off. I ain't dancing forever. I'm going off. Feel me? Just in his name's sake, whatever. If it look goofy, it look goofy. I'm outside. You know what I'm saying? But, RP Lionel, man. I love you.
Let's boogie!
Let's go see.
We're not gonna party yet.
Hey, Kurt. Hey, Kurt.
Yeah.
Hey, great job.
Oh, you're welcome.
Love you, Lino.
Don't touch yourself.
We love you, Lino.
One second. Kind of hard-headed like Lino a little bit.
Damn, man.
I want to say thank you to everybody that came out today. To show your love and respect. To our brother, our friend, our colleague. It's tough, man, but the only thing Lionel would want us to do is live life and be great. So if you want to really pay homage to Lionel after we leave here today, I want y'all to live life and be great. Whatever you set your mind to, you can accomplish. Don't let somebody tell you you can't do something. The only reason they're telling you you can't do it is because they tried and they failed. But that won't be your story.
What's up?
Can I get an amen?
Amen!
All right,
talk
now.
Back Monday, Yeti. This
Sunday.
Talk on back Monday, Yeti.
Champagne pounder.
Moment of silence. Moment of silence. 1 minute, please.
Secluded. You could have fixed that vacant apartment, built some equity, and that's how you could have concluded. But that can't be a conclusion. Non-sober thoughts considered inconclusive, mental abusive, but that's just your inner voice talking to you. You always have a choice in you. Use your mind to get outside your mind to mind the businesses. Now that's a business mindset. We set our minds to things that aren't real and material things that we can't have. It's time for you to risk it all for your inner peace, your energy, your energy. Let it emerge and see what can happen next. Cause you're up next to be the best that you can be. But you'll have to pay a fee. Now that's time, dedication, preparation, determination. And the whole time, it'll be your friends that are here. But is it worth it all? Will my parents see me shine before they fall? Can I have another productive fall to finish off the year strong? Why is it taking so long? Hold on, my young king, you gotta stay strong. You definitely do, for your inner self. You can't just do it by yourself. Let me know if you need any help, you know, back of your feet and shit. Karma's a bitch and you know you can defeat it. Just don't accept defeat. Just a couple more feet away from the other side of that door. After all that grinding, after all those chores, walking from store to store, refusing to be bored, and just in case no one ever told you before, your moment is here and it's all yours. I know your heart was torn, and it's time to soar far away so the pain will be no more. This is the word for anyone that thought they can't avoid. Just don't let them become null and void. Voice that opinion to your companions. Just don't let it become abandoned. Talk to someone, even if it's to yourself when you have nobody else. It's not always obvious. It's okay to rant and it's okay to vent. Just don't let the system milk you, because I know you lactose in your tolerance. But how much more can you tolerate? Because at this rate, anything less of happiness wouldn't be rational. Just let me ration with you. Matching trends as it's cold outside, cold-hearted. When I see clearly through my ice-cold lens, I know you feel me now. Instant visions prolific as you view my profile profoundly. I found reasoning for this vivid image. I'm aged now, if you will, and I can put that at my will. But will the winter come too soon this time? Or will the timber land 10 toes down? Or will you waste it all on paper?
Yes, you have a dream. You came here, and the process is not supposed to be comfortable. So if it hurts, welcome to the big leagues. If you feel like you're under heat, praise God. If you feel like you're being pressured, praise God. I went through 12 years of pressure. But when God looks like he's pulling you back, eventually he's going to let you go. And the further he pulls you back,
It's been a long day without you, my friend. And I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again. Why'd you have to leave so soon, yeah? Why'd you have to go? Why'd you have to leave me when I needed you the most? Cause I don't really know how to tell you without feeling much worse. I know you're in a better place, but it's always gonna hurt. Carry on, give me all the strength I need to carry on. It's been a long day without you, my friend. So cold, I'll be waiting right here for you till the day you're home. Carry on, give me all the strength I need to carry on. So let the light guide your way. Yeah, hold every memory as you go. Every road you take will always lead you home. Oh, oh, it's been a long day without you, my.